We're here at the Museum of Russian Art, the only museum of its kind in North America.
That's pretty impressive. How and why here in South Minneapolis?
Well, our founders, Ray and Susan Johnson, are Minnesota people, and they began by collecting a lot, thousands of Russian works, and had their gallery over on Bloomington, but then decided to serve Minnesotans and serve Americans by showcasing the vast amount of work that they have. So they're Minnesota people, and they created this special place for Minnesotans and for Americans.
Do you know, do you have a sense of whether that was dangerous work to collect these works or not?
I feel like it wasn't necessarily safe all the time, and Ray and Susan can tell lots of stories about how, you know, acquiring works in, as the Soviet Union was falling, and lots of interesting stories. But the good news is that we have, you know, they're all here and they're all safe and they're able to be appreciated now. Originally, this space was the Mayflower Church, built in a really unique style, in this Spanish mission style. I mean, I bet many Twin Cities people know about, you know, driving past this place on 35W and Diamond Lake Road. Well, it was built in this style by the church to attract a pastor that they really wanted to come here. The church ended up moving across the street, and then this was actually a funeral home for some years, and thankfully the Johnsons took it over in the early 2000s, and it was renovated and is what it is now. Currently, the exhibition on view in the main gallery is called Art and Conflict, and it is a juxtaposition between Soviet realism and nonconformism. So artists that were living and breathing in the same time in the Soviet Union, making either state-sanctioned work or completely underground provocative work. And so on the walls, you'll see them kind of interspersed and in conversation with each other. I think the one thing I hear the most from people stopping in at the museum were, number one, I've driven past here for years, I've never stopped in, and what a gem this place is. It is a beautiful space to walk into. It's a wonderful size of a museum where you can tour it in maybe an hour. So it's something really doable for your day. Also, it's a really wonderful opportunity to learn about the culture of Russian people, about their background, and it's a very rich history. It's the largest country in the world. So what a good opportunity to extend and learn about people that maybe we don't know that much about.
And maybe we need to know more about them again.
And very timely, right? I've personally learned a lot, and then have had a lot of opportunities to be around, you know, the 50 to 60,000 Russian-speaking people in the Twin Cities. It's, I mean, it's a wonderful place to be. It's a great opportunity.